So I watched Rear Window recently. It was fine. It was interesting. But there was one thing I could not get past, and that was Grace Kelly's tiny little voice. Whoa. Ah. Oh. I was like, what, bitch? Speak up! Yeah, I can't hear you, bitch! Louder! I want to hear what you're saying! No, no. Mm-mm. This voice was designed. This voice is perfectly received by the male eardrum. Never too high. She's not a shrill bitch. And never too low. You know what that means, and it's not that. Never that. You could hear the spittle on her wet baby lips. She sounded as though a doe was suddenly given the ability to speak. And all the women at this time sounded this way. You know, like Audrey Hepburn. And, you know, I like love Audrey Hepburn too, or whatever, but they sounded the same exact way. You know, like I guess they went to like the same finishing school to learn how to walk and talk like a lady. All the consonants were stretched out. And the vowels never quite found their shape. They always sounded like, oh, everything's wonderful. Isn't it wonderful? Everything? This world that men have designed for us. They're very clever, those men. You have to give them that. So I recently found out why these classic beauties sounded like this in these classic films. And it's because when they would come in for an audition, the old Hollywood director would jizz right in their mouths. And if the young starlet were lucky enough to get the part, she'd have to keep it in her mouth for the whole shoot. Terrible, awful. Imagine that. A Dixie cup's worth of jizz being stored in your cheeks like chipmunks for upwards of 40 business days. No! Oh, can you picture having to spit out a load at night into a shot glass and put it back in before hair and makeup in the morning? No! Terrible. Oh. Now I guess we know why their mouths are always in that shape. Oh. Ah. Oh. Mm-hmm. Finishing school indeed.